So if you are crafting your assignment properly, group and pair work can be extremely enriching. The goal in group or pair work is collaborative production. So oftentimes when you have a big class, students feel shy, they feel embarrassed to participate, and they're often looking for feedback or the approval of their peers. And that's why you see in discussion boards, you'll find that the quiet and reserved students are more likely to give their input because you're not putting them on the spot or they're not being put on the spot. So in group and pair work, you're giving individual students space to reflect on their learning, right? They're able to discuss a variety of topics with their classmates. They're willing to be more open and free. And then they're also practicing sharing with the larger class. So use pair work and group work to have to allow the students to work together, to work in collaboration, to be able to synthesize and analyze different texts or different videos, different arguments, and then work through them together, and then create their own analysis and create their own discussions based on what prompts and what materials you have given them. And sometimes there are different techniques when it comes to group work and pair work. Do you pair a strong student with a weak student? Do you pair a more talkative student with a quiet student? And also do not forget that as an instructor, you should model what a good interaction looks like. Put a time limit on the interaction. Give them reminders. So if you say, okay, guys, over the next 5 minutes, da 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 da, and you've given them the prompts, you know, a couple minutes in, remind them, okay, 3 minutes left, you should be moving on to the other person speaking. All right, guys, 1 minute left, let's close this up, let's wrap it up and be ready to present to the class, and walk around as the instructor. Make sure the students are engaging in the communications and not just wasting time. And I'm going to give you in the next lesson or in the next attachment, you'll find some good examples of how to group and pair your students.